Hello, everybody. It is July 31st, 2014. A little bit, about maybe 12:45 p.m. I'm here to talk about gadgets, and the first gadget I think you all should have is the little remote control to your camcorder. There you go. All right. Gadgets. All right. Well, you know, if you got records, you got audio equipment, you've got Y adapters, headphone adapters, there's even a cable TV adapter. You got adapters, headphone, stereo to mono. Collect these things up, right? And of course, you probably have a few extra head shells laying around. You know, who doesn't? You know, everybody has them. Well, here's a little trick here. Next time you're at a flea market, look for an 8mm wind-up movie camera that has a D-mount lens. You can tell because as you turn your back from the vendor there at the flea market, you can unscrew it. It's a 5/8 inch mount. Look for a wide angle lens, about 13 millimeter focal length or less. You can look at your stylus points with this. It does not replace a microscope, but it does a pretty good job. So, go to the flea market, look for 8 millimeter movie cameras, and buy a lens. Second, what I have found is that little numerical scale on the back of your tone arm for cartridge pressure, stylus pressure, is pitifully inaccurate. I got, for a little under 13 bucks, a little digital scale. This little baby is showing me how off my tracking pressure was. Hey, for years and years, I've just used that little numerical ring on the back of the tone arm. And I promise never do it again. Please forgive me. This thing actually came with a battery inside it, and the goof who sent it to me sent 6 extra batteries in it. So, I got batteries for life. Actually, I'm going to send the batteries off. A mirror. Believe it or not, little tiny mirror. You don't know how important that can be. Put it on your platter. Drop your stylus on it. You can check your azimuth. All right, to see if you've got a shim, if your needle is hitting squarely in that groove. Why does this work? Because it magnifies, it doubles the error. You can get a visual cue. As you can see in this little inset photo here, this Audio Technica is miserably off. What I had to do actually was loosen the screws into the little attachment on the tone arm and twist it a little bit. Yeah, the $695 Reco cut, which I am really displeased with. Folks, go to vinylengine.com. Download a bare wall protractor. Yes, folks, 2 nodal points. Set your cartridge in alignment with those 2 nodal points. Actually, you're going to get pretty much a best compromise with all that. But still, if a lot of you got a Techniques and you got that little plastic clip and you line up your stylus point with that little notch in the little clip on there, don't do it. Get a bare wall protractor. It'll give you a headache setting the thing up, but it's you will notice a difference. All right. Now this really isn't a gadget, it's another thing I bought on eBay. It's an Ortofon Concord 30. Back in the 80s, when I bought the Phase Linear 8000 Series 2, I had an Ortofon Concord 20. This is an all-in-one cartridge head shell, mounts right into your arm, very low mass. Being a Concord 30 means that it needs a Stylus 30, and this came without a, well, came with a little mount, but the cantilever's broken off. It's there to keep dust out of there. Unfortunately, I can't use this little baby because I bought this Pioneer PLL1000 used and didn't get all the accessory parts for it. But when I bought my 8000 Series 2, which is the identical turntable, I had a Concord 20 and I loved it. Alrighty now, past the gadget phase now. Stack of things I bought since the last time I posted. Starting off with some shellac. Strauss waltzes. Al Goodman and his orchestra. Strauss waltzes in dance tempo. So they're good for ballroom dancing. All of these are nice, shiny shellac, uncracked, unbroken. You know, there is a special place in my heart for these shellac albums. And it's really so nice to find a complete set that are unbroken, uncracked, and still a little bit shiny, too. They sound good. They sounded a little bit trebly, so I don't know, you know, if you record them into your computer, you make MP3s, whatever, for your iPod, another gadget, or you just want to play them without risking your antique shellacs. Well, anyway, we have the Blue Danube, the Wiener Blut, which is Vienna Blood or Vienna Spirit, Southern Roses Waltz, Wine, Women, and Song, Tales from the Vienna Woods, Voices of Spring, Frühlingsstimmen, yes, made popular by the Three Stooges, Emperor Waltz, An Artist's Life, Kunstleben. Anyway, nice set of Strauss waltzes. It's funny, you know, you play these, you put them on your record player, and you're like, oh, I remember that song. Yes, I remember that piece. So, a nice set in good condition. $1 per disc at the flea market. Mario Landfill. Yes, oh, by the way, the Strauss was from 1940. Mario Landfill. Mario Lanza, actually. This set from 19... I believe it, this... Yeah, this one has a date, this one doesn't. This set is from 1949. I bought this because this was a rescue mission, actually. A nice three-disc set. Three-disc RCA Red Seal. Now, when I look over these 78, these shellac albums, and I look for cracks and brokens, well, one disc is cracked all the way through, one is cracked only on one side. I consider this a rescue mission because I know if I didn't buy them, they would end up broken completely and unplayable. As they are playable. It pops 78 times per minute, so what can I tell you? I just couldn't let it go for knowing that something from 1948 was going to wind up in worse condition if I didn't buy it. So, a couple pieces from Verdi, from Nuttall, Puccini, Caudillo, Kern, and Caper. Oh, tenor star of the MGM motion picture That Midnight Kiss. So, I'm assuming, or maybe I'm stretching my little authority here, this is a soundtrack album from a movie. There you go. So, it's show tunes. Yeah, there you go. All right. Suite number one, Opus 46, Peer Gynt. Another set of albums. Actually, this is a two-record, two-disc set. Again, a buck a disc from 1948. Yes. This is suite number one. There was a suite number two, Opus 55. But this is suite number one, Opus 46. This has Hall of the Mountain King and bum 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 bum. And what is it called? Morning Mood. Ba 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 ba. Hey, if I could sing, I'd be on the records. So, nice set. Unfortunately, you know, they're a little bit warped. This set was a little bit warped. Regardless, I bought them because it was complete. Lacquer had a nice shine to them, but they're a little bit warped. Okay, now for some new old stuff. I just happened to walk into a record store, and I found Led Zeppelin 3. Yeah, baby. Nice. What is this from, 1973? Reissue, still has the little whirligig inside. It is a two record set. Well, let me show you this. It is a two record set. So, you have the wonderful triple gatefold. The companion record is practically the album all over, but all outtakes, alternate tracks, alternate edits, rough mix with Dulcimer. But the companion album, The Immigrant Song, was an alternate mix. Friends, the track with no vocal, an alternate mix of Celebration Day. A rough mix of the first recording of Since I've Been Loving You. Bathroom Sound, it says Bathroom Sound track, no vocal, which is actually Out on the Tiles. Yeah. Yeah. Side 2. A rough mix of Gallows Pole. A rough mix of That's the Way. Jennings Farm Blues, which is a rough mix of guitar overdubs. And Key to the Highway, Trouble in Mind, which is a Brunsey Seeger song, which was unreleased on the original LP. Now, why didn't they include the B-side of the 45 RPM of Immigrant Song? But anyway, I've been playing the companion record. I have not even played the legitimate album yet. It brought tears to my eyes. Honestly, folks, I kind of cried over this. This was nice to hear it fresh, clean vinyl. I guess that Atlantic got their record presses out of their junk file and junk warehouse and got them running again, but they're nice and quiet where they need to be quiet. I take a stab at saying that they're pressed by RTI, but I don't know. Good. I love this. They also had Led Zeppelin too, but I already spent too much money on that, as well as Talking Heads, Fear of Music, one of my all-time favorites. This also, 180 gram, pressed by RTI, probably from Digital Master, is my guess, but has the original industrial embossing on the cover, front and back, as the original inner sleeve of the thermograph and the lyrics. And it never goes back in the case. But, you know, of course, you know I get vinyl, poly sleeves. I don't like paper against my precious vinyl, but good to hear this nice clean pressing by RTI. Also pressed by RTI, more songs about buildings and food, and my mouth has been watering for this album for a long time. This is my Talking Heads dance album. I love, not that I dance that much, but Talking Heads. This is one of the hippest albums of the Talking Heads. Again, has the original LP inner sleeve reproduction. Pressed by RTI and 180 grams vinyl. Nice, good, clean reissue. And just as the last one would not go back in the case. Now, the next one's a bit of a surprise for me. I don't know how many of you guys have YouTube out there. But I go through YouTube and I see, you know, and there was one video that said, gotta have that record, and another one about the XYZ record company story, you know, whatever, you know, because, well, I'm a musically and record collecting oriented kind of guy. I came across a video called Death for the Whole World to See. It is a band of three brothers from Detroit, okay? They played punk before there was punk. This is a surprise. I'm telling you, man, this is genuine punk. Before before Sid Vicious, yeah, before Steve Bators, before the Dead Boys, before, you know, the original recordings, I think, what did it say? I think it was from, okay, songs written in 74, yeah, the bulk of these, no, not the bulk of them, all of them, were written in 1974. When did punk hit the big scene? 78? Copyright 1975, Elect Music. Copyright produced 2009 by Drag City Incorporated in Chicago. I'm telling you, man, these guys are hot. They're great. I love this. There are two other albums, but it's not payday yet, okay? That'll be for next posting. But, I cannot gush enough enthusiasm over this album. It's incredible. And, by the way, it's a nice, clean recording. Again, quiet where it needs to be quiet. You drop the point pops in the groove, and you hear nothing until the guys are playing. So, I emailed to Drag City, and I said, good job. You know, I don't know who's pressing your records, but, you know, they're pristine, they're immaculate. So they replied, it's pressed by RTI. Ha ha. Goodness, breeding shows, doesn't it? Well, here's another one. Pressed by RTI. This is Mobile Fidelity Sound Lab. This is Silver Label. So, not 180 gram Silver Label. Standard weight vinyl, still very flat vinyl. And keeping true to RTI, because RTI presses all the Mobile Fidelities as well. This is a nice reissue of my favorite Sisters of Mercy album. Ah, Dominion, Mother Russia, Flood One, Lucretia, 1959, This Corrosion, Flood Two, Driven Like the Sow, and Neverland. Hot record. I like this. One thing I did notice, it's not very loud. For Sisters of Mercy, this, well, you know, the vinyl only gives you so much room to cut a wide groove, so, apparently, you know, my nose is running. Anyway, good, worth the money, Sisters of Mercy, if you like Sisters of Mercy, it's worth the money. Alright, now, keeping up with my oldies, Let It Rot by The Ruddles. After buying a transparent vinyl of the Beatles, I just had to hear it fresh on clean, new vinyl. Once again, one of my favorite Beatles, the last studio album, and here's a mistake. It's 180 grams. It's a green apple. Which pisses me off. Green apple. The original Let It Be had a red apple. It was their last studio album. It was their last thing together. And it came out originally with a red apple, not a green apple. And that just, what's wrong with these people? Can't they get it right? But, well, hey, it's more about the music, though, isn't it? Green apple. Idiots. This is an album that my sister had when I was a kid. She had a General Electric console stereo with a Glazer Steers GS400 record changer. That stereo is what put its hooks in me for phonographs. But the soundtrack, music from the Paramount Motion Picture score, Hatari, Henry Mancini. This, I mean, I played this until you could see the other side. RCA, Victor. Look at that beautiful label. I love that label. I love that dog. You know, in Baltimore, they had this huge nipper, which is, they called it, I don't know if it's actually the official name, but the phonograph and the big dog, it was a huge thing. I think somebody eventually bought it and didn't know what to do with it. I guess it just didn't fit on the shelf, so they didn't know what to do with it. So, Here's the sad thing about this album, because I am going to be looking for another copy of this. This record is so warped that it just throws my tone arm up in the air. But, yes, it does say Living Stereo, LSP, Living Stereo. Those Living, and it's from 1962. Wonderful, but warped. This brings back memories. Okay, now I've got Urania Records. Ooh, is this going to give me cancer? It is a high fidelity demonstration record. And it has an RIAA frequency curve and all this technical data on it. The first four bands, side one, a 30 cycle frequency, a 50 cycle, 100, 1000, and 10,000. So it has a little beep, beep, beep. Okay. Clean record with damp cloth. Microgroove long playing. When it says microgroove, you can be pretty sure that it ain't stereo. And this ain't stereo. But it's got some good musical pieces. From Fala, The Three-Cornered Hat. From Tchaikovsky, Swan Lake. From Ponchielli, La Gioconda. From Donani, Symphonic Minutes. From B-O-I-T-O, Boito? Boito? I don't know. Hey, if I don't hear it pronounced, I'd never know. Mephistopheles. Three tracks from Wagner. We have Entrance of the Gods into Valhalla, Ride of the Valkyries, Ride of the Valkyries, and the finale of Götterdämmerung. Frequency response of this record is 30 to 18,000 cycles. I like these old gimmicky things. What I like most about this old gimmicky thing is that it is a Urania label. And I've never heard of this label before. It's an oddball. Yep. I don't know how many times I've told you guys I like oddballs. I like these old gimmicky, you know. Come and hear what my stereo can do. And you got a train running from one speaker to another, you know. Get in there. Gunshot in your left speaker and a guy flopping over dead on your right speaker. Okay. Now here's an oddball. It's a comedy. It's a party record. It is Kay Stevens with not so great songs that were left out of great movies for obvious reasons. It's on the Liberty label. It is microgroove, so that means it is not stereo. But with a little line here. This album is available in monaural and in stereo. And if you're old like me, you will remember that your sister paid an extra buck to get stereo. Yeah, stereo was a buck more. But Liberty label, mono, this is a party record. It's, you know, parodies of things. Freud and his electric couch. Sodom and Gomorrah Revisited, The Ugly American, or Cranky Yankee Hanky Panky, Splendor in the Grass, or Lawn Parties Can Be Fun, Frankenstein in Three-Quarter Time, don't confuse that with Edgar Wintergreen, and the Chapman Report Marching Song. The Chapman Report, that was a sexual habit study somewhere in the mid-60s, so it parodies that. Side 2, Judgment at Nuremberg, or A Hun and His Honey Bun, Cleopatra, which is the most expensive song on the album, Birdman of Alcatraz, or The Ornithologist's Lament. Then there is a medley of Lady Chatterley's Lover, or Something Cool in the Hot House. Whatever Happened to Baby Jane? Good question. Lawrence of Arabia Rides Again. Then it says, sing along with, period, 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 question mark, question mark, question mark. Actually, you had to buy the album and open it before you see that it was Sing Along with God. A little irreverent, irreverent things kind of make me nervous. Certain things you shouldn't mess with, boy. But anyway, Sing Along with God. It's actually a lot of ad-lib, a lot of fun. I'll play a track later on and post it. One other, Jean-Michel Jarre. I have to tell you, I am German-blooded, and I tend to, if I run into a word that I don't understand, I pronounce, because German has no silent letters. You guys out there, if you want to buy a Porsche does not exist. It is a Porsche. Don't forget that. Okay, Oxygen in how many parts? Six parts total. It is one of those electronic artists. They stuck labels on the cover, on the jacket, and I want to shoot them, but I picked it up anyway, because it's on the original French label. So, just for that alone, being on the original French label, from 1976, by the way, I bought that. Now, of course, Led Zeppelin 3 now is going to spur me to buy the Led Zeppelin 2. And Oxygen is going to spur me to buy Magnetic Fields and Equinox, because I like this guy. It's good music. I love electronic music. Okay, now, in my door this morning, here's one more gadget that you guys should have too. It's a razor blade. Get back to the gadget part. This just came today. This was an eBay find. And what the hell was this? Well, first off, it's an empty cover of the Moody Blues for All Our Children's Childrens. All to Our Children's Children's Children. It's an empty cover. Packing material. One of my favorites, from 1981. Still sealed in shrink wrap. It's a cutout, Polyrock changing hearts. Oh, I love it. Still sealed from 1981. An obscure band that I love to death. And I'm gonna cry. I'm overjoyed. I love it. Now, I remember being at a party. Well, it was a party at where I lived. And I was playing this record, and I remember somebody commenting and said, "Where do you find this music?" This was one of the albums that I was playing. And I played this after I was playing Talking Heads' Fear of Music. And a little thank you business card. From MC Kostek. From the Velvet Underground Appreciation Society. One word, velvetundergroundrecords.com. Well, that's interesting. Polyrock, Changing Hearts. I think the second album. Love it. Well, anyway, apparently my next post will be after I buy two more Jean-Michel Jarre albums and Led Zeppelin too. Anyway, I've been yakking around for 17 and a half minutes now. Maybe less, actually, because I let the camera run and was breathing. So anyway, go out and buy some records. Go out and buy some gadgets. Don't forget to go to a flea market and get some Kleenex. Also, buy some record label t-shirts, too, because it makes people wonder, you know, about what you're up to. Yes, the brain. Klaus Schulze's album label. Alright. Okay, I'm going to turn this thing off now. So, see you the next time I buy some more records and I'm gushing with pride.